Hi there, beach friends. We have so many fantastic things to talk about today. First, let's talk about timing, as I had this shelling trip booked for over a week, and Hurricane Nicole decided to hit the East Coast the day before. So there's going to be all sorts of fantastic piles of shells for us to go through, and yes, we are definitely going to admire quite a few really fantastic treasures. But that honestly wasn't even the best part of my trip here. I got to see not one, but two live critters that I have never seen before, including one I have been dying to say hi to. So, if you're ready to start our post-hurricane adventure, let's go to the beach. So we are going to have so much fun. We're going on a shell tour with SWFL Shell Guide and Nautical Life Shelling. So these two shell tour companies used to be two individual companies, but since Hurricane Ian has come about, we have a lot of changes, myself included. So this is one of my local beaches. They're still pretty beat up. So we will be enjoying Kice Island today. Like I said, we did go on a shell tour. We are going to travel to Kice Island via boat, and of course I'm going to take in Kice. I haven't seen this part of the island since the hurricane, so it'll be a little bit for me kind of seeing how much it has changed. The tide is pretty much dead low at this point. It will be coming in. It's not really going to make all that much of a difference. And I didn't get an opportunity to go shelling with Hurricane Ian. It was just a mess. So I'm kind of excited to go hurricane shelling this time. It was after Nicole. I'm super bummed about all of the damage that happened on the East Coast, and I'm probably not alone. I was very surprised at how much damage that Category 1 hurricane caused. But today, so Nicole has passed. That was yesterday. We are here on Kice Island, and there's definitely going to be some treasures to be found. Here we have what looks to be like an almost perfect apple murex with its little ridges and color. Very beautiful. And here is a angel wing. Doesn't have its little scoop on the inside, but still a very beautiful angel wing shell. Now this was really cool. So this is a cut-ribbed arc, which happens to be one of my favorite arcs anyway, but it is alive. And look at the periostracum. It's hairy. Isn't that awesome? And of course it made me think about the hairy tritons and some other shells that do develop that natural periosteum. I thought that was really, really neat. And here we have a very lazy Florida fighting conch. And there's the critter. And it's just kind of, it's like, hey, get off my shell. But it's not really active. So let's take a look at one that's a little bit more active. You can see the two eye stalks. You can see its proboscis. That's that little trunk looking thing there. So that's how those little critters move. They kind of swing out. Their body is called the foot. And in a minute, you're going to see why it actually got that name, the foot, because really, that's how the critter moves. So I know it was feeling a little bit lazy, but for whatever reason, once I put it down, it decided it didn't like where it was. So it's going to try to move. And I think schlumping, I think that is a good term for what this little critter's doing. It is not very graceful at all. Kind of just schlumping along. So that is how the locomotion of a Florida fighting conch looks like. That is how those little critters get around. They just kind of lurch around. Again, I like calling it schlumping. So here's Kice. Definitely looks different to me. I know it already looks dead. It always kind of did look half dead to me, just the way the island is. And here we have a little smattering of shells. Let's get down. Let's see what all is here. It's pretty much, oh, a jingle. Yeah, let's grab that. pretty much what we usually see here is a yellow prickly cockle. Here is a Florida prickly cockle. So your cockles, your arcs, not really so much your scallops, really. It's really those arcs and cockles are the most predominant and really, really common, sometimes the clamshells too, that you'll see. But we're gonna try to see if we can find something a little bit more interesting. Very nice orange cone, but first I'm gonna pick up this Florida worm snail. Then I'm gonna pick up the Florida cone. So here's two shells that do have the name Florida in them. That's a Florida cone and a Florida worm snail. Pretty cool. And look at here, we have a Florida horse conch. That is the Florida state shell, the horse conch. We're gonna find a couple today. That's one of those juvenile little critters, or it's just a shell, it's not a critter. This is also just a shell, but I never find it anywhere other than here on Kais. This is a thick lucene, not the most attractive shell I've ever seen, for sure. I'm actually not even gonna keep it, but I only see them here on Kais. Ooh, another jingle. So I figured I'll just go ahead and say hi. And yep, that is just a piece of a lightning whelk. Womp, womp. Oh, but that is not a piece. That is an entire pair whelk, and it is beautiful. Gorgeous coloring on that. Nice size, gorgeous pair whelk. Hello, Kais. I can't wait to spend some time with you. I love this island. This is really fun. This is one of the islands that you probably, if you were going to go on a shell tour, very good chance you would end up here on Kais Island. I do have my own kayak. However, the marina I used to launch from has been destroyed by Hurricane Ian. So for the time being, in order to get some beautiful banded tulips like this, I'm going to need to take that shell tour with my friends Carlos and Ali. That beautiful true tulip. I have a very hard time finding true tulips, and I know the color is a little bit muted, and I suspect that is just the way that that shell is. That's probably going to stay that kind of muted color. Yay, it's so much more satisfying when I go to pick a piece of shell up and the entire shell comes out. Fantastic. So here we have another lovely look. Oh, that's real pretty looking lightning whelk. I said another, I don't know, is that the first one we found? I suspect we'll find a few, just like this apple murex. Lovely, lovely shell. And oh, I see it. Oh, super special. Yep, that little brown shell, that is actually called a Sanibel turrid. And I've only found maybe three of them, and all of them down in the 10,000 Island area. Crazy, not on Sanibel, but down here. So that is a Sanibel turrid. Really beautiful condition, gorgeous. Now here we have a big old giant Atlantic cockle, and I'm on the move because word on the beach is that all the shells are a little bit this away. So I'm traveling south trying to get to some of those bigger shell piles. But, you know, I have to stop and kind of admire, perhaps take this top snail. Yep, I'm gonna get distracted. Oh, well, you gotta stop and pick up a hinged spiny jewel box. How cool is that? So I love the spiny jewel boxes. To find them hinged, even better. Oh. So I did recognize the bottom as a big old moon snail. Unfortunately, it is not in, you know, it's a little worse for wear. So probably leave that here. Wow. So that's a common auger. Gorgeous. Gorgeous looking shell. Big. I'd like that one just because the size was just very big shell. All right. This looks like cone territory. Uh-huh. There we go. Gorgeous alphabet cone. Woohoo! Awesome. I know it's a little bit of beach stuff on top, but really beautiful looking alphabet cone. Here we have another one of those banded tulips. You can pretty much guarantee you'll get one or two if you do go on one of these shell tours down here on Kais. They do seem to be quite abundant down here. Wow. Awesome. So yeah, okay, this is looking pretty good to me. These massive shell piles, and check this out, There's so many shells all over. Oh, yeah, this other alphabet cone. So somebody missed it. I mean, it looks like this definitely has been picked through at this point, but there's so many fabulous shells. This little alphabet, well, not even little, this alphabet cone got left behind. Yay me. Yay alphabet cone. Oh, yeah, I mean, I'm right here. I might as well get these two banded tulips and this true tulip while I'm at it. Yeah, gorgeous, gorgeous shells. So these are some really fun shell piles. Okay, here is a hinged. This is a little bit more common, but I really do like the calico clams. And since this is hinged, I'm probably gonna hold on to that. Whoa, it looks awesome. All right, what else we got? Oh, must have seen this little critter move. You're not supposed to be up here. You should be all the way down there. So we're gonna help a mollusk out. There you go, friend. We're gonna drop you off. And let's see, yep, we'll pick this up instead. A lovely looking lightning whelk. Whoa. All right, it's, where should I go? There's shells everywhere. It's awesome. Oh, another hinged spiny jewel box. Really, really awesome. I will probably not pass any of those by. I will pick up every single hinged spiny jewel box I see. Okay, please be whole. Please be whole. All right. Isn't that pretty? So that's a Florida horse conch. It's not one of those big ones. I know we all like to get those big ones, but the smaller ones called ponies, I think they're gorgeous as well. Super happy with that. And this real pretty lace murex. It's quite lacy. It is empty. Gorgeous looking lace murex. So I'm having myself a good old time in these shell piles. And I kind of just right sitting there for me is a sand dollar, a single sand dollar. I don't know how it survived and made it all the way up on this shell pile, but I feel like it has my name on it, and I'm going to go ahead and bring that home. Oh, fantastic! A gaudy nautica, also known as a colorful moon snail. So that is in the moon snail family. It just happens to be quite colorful. And that fantastic yellow scallop, that almost never happens. So that is a calico scallop. I rarely find them yellow, so really happy about that. Another! Yay! So that's a spiny jewel box. And again, it's hinged, and you gotta be careful with those hinges. So if I leave it in that shape, that's pretty much how that hinge is gonna dry out. If I want it closed, I'm gonna need to kind of keep it closed and let it dry out that way. So the hinges can be a little tricky. Don't gotta worry about that with the gastropods. So that is another Florida cone, gorgeous Florida cone. The gastropods only have one shell, unlike the bivalves that will have two. Beach friends. All right, so I'm a little bit nuts about the Florida fighting conchs. Look at how beautifully zigzaggy that shell is. Oh, yeah, there are some shells I just cannot resist. And it is time for me to be quiet and let you enjoy some beach time. This trip was so much fun for me. It really was kind of hard for me to be quiet. Now this big old apple murex, a little bit on that tan side, right? Looking a little bit funky. Now, is that going to clean up? Well, I think we should find out. So I soaked it in bleach, and yes, as a matter of fact, I got that tan out. So that's all I did. Once again, that magical bleach, I just soaked it, and I bothered because it's a big shell. I mean, that is one big apple murex, and we already know that cleans up real pretty. Okay, what am I hunting here? All right, that is another moon snail. Look at that, kind of weird. It also has that kind of tan coloration on it. That one I did not bother cleaning up just because it had a couple little pits and things in it. What else do we got? All right, another Florida cone. Terrific. Nice color. It's intact. I do see a spiny jewel box. All right, it is not hinged, but it's got some nice spikes on there. Terrific. Spiny jewel box and a Florida cone. Oh, wait, but wait, there's more. And an apple murex. Terrific. Yep, nice little. Was worth the bend. All right, what else is going to come jumping out at us? No, there's your arcs and your some conchs. Guess there was nothing there. Just wanted to give you a little peek at what's down there, but this one I'm gonna go ahead and take again with that zigzag. That is a juvenile Florida fighting conch with beautiful coloring. Well, hi there, horse conch. So that is a Florida horse conch, and I do see another little piece of orange here. Guys, that's a rose murex. I was like, no way. So yeah, the horse conch, and then that, yeah, that's pretty sweet. A rose murex. So that's like a bucket list shell. And I'm like humming at this point. I'm like, oh, that was so fun. And this is a paper fig, so the shells are still coming at us. Nice looking paper fig. Wonderful. And this is what the area looks like. So the area to the right, that's kind of what I was calling before, like the alphabet cone zone, even though you can find them to the left. To the left is really more the piles. On the right was a little bit more of the muck, and it was things are gonna be a little bit wetter. Up, oh, and you're gonna find possibly cones like that. Look at how big it is. That is a monster. So they get to about 3 inches. Which isn't it gorgeous? And I didn't want you to wait, so it did clean up really, really nice as well. Again, I soaked it in bleach, and typically I would probably give that a dip in acid. I'd even spend more time on it, but I don't have all of my equipment really kind of set up after the hurricane, so just know that it does clean up really, really nice. So you can see the tide coming in. Kais is typically not the kind of island you're going to kind of walk along the sand and pick up shells. You're really going to be more inland on this island, going through stumps and whatnot. That is a live banded tulip. And there is a very good reason. We're just going to stop and say hi to that. I'm going to show you in just a second. We're just going to go ahead and pick up this Florida horse conch. And then let's turn our attention back to the tulip. It has that same locomotion as the Florida fighting conch. So it has that foot. This one has an operculum on it as well, that little brown piece. And it does the same kind of schlumping thing. So that's how some of those snails kind of cruise along, and other ones just kind of, I don't know what you would call that. Well, the schlumping. All right. We're in alphabet cone territory, and I am actively looking for them. Let's see if I manage to find any here. Oh, it's not an alphabet cone, but it sure is pretty. So it's a common nutmeg. Beautiful. Awesome little, I love the little beads on it. And here we have a lace murex. Excellent. Empty lace murex. As well as that nutmeg. What else we got here? Okay, partially buried. So that's a moon snail. That is a colorful moon snail. A little chipped, but that's okay. We're gonna keep it anyway. Oh, and while we're here, might as well snag that Florida cone too. Oh, the top is real pretty on that one. Yep, awesome. And a little jasper cone. So that's another type of cone we're gonna find today. We have the alphabet cone, the Florida cone, and a jasper cone. And no, I have never found a live cone. Never, never, not yet anyway. That is a shark eye. So that's another moon snail. But that one is called a shark eye. It's a pretty good looking shark eye. And oh, that's so satisfying when the whole shell is there. I love that. So another alphabet cone. And the alphabet cones are very, very collectible, desirable. They're one of the shells that I kind of feel like everybody likes to get, those alphabet cones. Yeah. To find so many on the same day, I'm having a ball. All right, another nutmeg. Nice color on that common nutmeg. Excellent. And then I'm kind of up here a little bit more. I'm hoping my Junonia will find me. And in the meantime, I found another paper fig. So I'm all over the place. I'm down in the water. I didn't spend too much time up near the trees. A little bit, though. Again, just making myself available for my Junonia to find me. It hasn't found me yet. That's okay. Because I'm having a lot of time in the meantime. You know, waiting for it to find me and having days like this, I don't mind. I am having so much fun. Love these piles. I know, this is crazy. Look, even for me, this is an insane amount of shells. Kais is fantastic, but this is just crazy. So I do feel like Nicole kind of helped out a little bit and pushed some goodies up onto the beach. Now, beach friends. Okay, this is a colorful moon snail, but it's alive. So that white kind of ridged thing, that is its operculum. I'm like just beside myself at this point. I've seen millions of these colorful moon snails, never saw a live one. And I had no idea that its operculum was white. So I'm just, wow. I'm having one of those wow moments. So that's what a live critter. Now, in the beginning, we kind of saw its body. It looked like it was colorful, for lack of a better term. So that is a live, living, colorful moon snail. That was pretty cool. Oh, sorry, buddy. That would be terrible to leave you upside down. There you go. Oh, that was cool. That was really, really cool. So this is another moon snail. Same family, different variety. That is a shark eye. Yeah, it's okay shape. It's decent size, so probably hold on to that. And this banded tulip while I'm here. Might as well, right? All right, piece or hole. Oh, love when you get a little bit of resistance. Yet another really awesome looking lightning whelk. Nice size, gorgeous color. Another. So usually if I just find one, I'm like, yay, to find multiple hinged spiny jewel boxes. Again, I'm having such a fantastic time. And I'm trying to be present. Like, I am here on this island. I'm having the best time, enjoying the beauty, all the things I'm discovering. Oh. And I don't know if it's because I'm just a little still discombobulated because of the hurricane and everything, but I'm just so joyful and grateful and happy about this really, really orange Florida horse conch. Very, very cool. All right, but wait, there's more. Oh, hello, horse conch. You are not done with your shell yet. So that is a live Florida horse conch. Poor thing's probably been picked up a couple times at this point. So we're going to find somewhere safe. Yeah, let's just put you there. There you go, buddy. Another apple murex. Another alphabet cone. And funny, all the other ones, I haven't found like an orange one in a long time. The other alphabet cones were much darker, the chocolate variety. That's the first like golden one I found in a while. Certainly not complaining, just kind of pointing it out there. I'd kind of feel like those were more common, but as it turns out for me lately, a little bit more on the rare side. So now I'm kind of moseying back to the north part of Kais. I do know at some point we'll have to leave. But in the meantime, I'm going to pick up as many of these alphabet cones as I can find. Yet another alphabet cone. Yeah, it's pretty darn awesome. And I'm not the only one here. So imagine everybody else is also finding tons and tons of great stuff. Now, this I just wanted to show you because it was kind of flying below the radar. So there is a cone here, but it's mostly buried. And sometimes you're just looking for little pieces of exposed shell. Now, I've been doing this for a couple years. I'm pretty good, not the best though. Allie with SWFL Shell Guide, who's part of this tour, she can spot those from like a mile away. She is amazing. So it's another benefit of going out. If you go with a tour guide, they are going to help you find the goodies. I literally was looking for a limpet. I can't believe I found one. So this is a cayenne keyhole limpet. Yep, I was looking for one, and check this out. All right, so this is another colorful moon snail, but it's all wonky. The color is all wrong. It's almost devoid of any color except for those. So it's not albino. It still has those little brown specks on it. I thought that was really cool. And I know it's a little chipped, but it's an alphabet cone. So still definitely gonna hold on to that. And again, it's kind of like on the brown side, not really that golden color. And friends, check this out. So this is a live spiny jewel box. How awesome is that? Look at those crazy spikes. So I have seen them live before. The critter, it just looks kind of gummy. It just looks like kind of like your cockles, just like that pink gummy looking critter. So that is alive and amazing and gorgeous. So we're just going to leave it here in its little pool. So at this point, I'm just like over the moon. Like I'm having so much fun. I'm feeling so very grateful. I found so many cool things. I've experienced so many cool things. And I feel like the universe said, you know what? We know you've had a hard time and you're a little bit discombobulated with the hurricane and everything. I got something else for you. And then this happens. An octopus. I have been dying to see an octopus out in the wild. And I could not believe it. I looked down. And there it is in all its glory, and it's beautiful. I was so excited, and I was so worried that I wasn't recording. And so I got, believe me, a lot of stuff going on in my excitement. So I don't actually know what kind of octopus this is. I couldn't nail down just one specific species. I know that these type of octopus have been found before. At the water's edge, I've seen people pick them up in shells, and I was just so happy to finally see one. And oh, buddy, now you're up here. And frankly, it looks like you're crawling the wrong way. All right, you should definitely be going toward the water. So at this point, I can't, no way am I gonna let it like start crawling up the beach. So I'm gonna help a little critter out. And I do apologize. I know you can't see great. I believe me, I had a lot going on. I was so excited. I'm like, oh my God, it's an octopus. I'm trying to record it and I can't wait to share it with you guys. And now I'm gonna try to pick it up gently, ever so gently, get it back into the water where it belongs. So I got to interact a little bit with it. There you go, friend. Because I did, you know, I try to be respectful of the animals. I feel like that was respectful. It needed a little help. Just kind of got it back in the water. So it didn't really disturb it. So I was having a great time before. Now I'm like over the moon. Oh, it was truly, truly one of the most magical couple of hours I've had out on the beach. And I just was feeling so grateful. And I thought about it, like, what did I need today? I didn't need anything. I had a shell bag and a ride to an island. That's it. This is all provided by Mother Nature. The smells, the sights, the shells, the weather, the beauty, all of it. So I really, again, I was feeling very, very grateful, very, very excited, and really, really peaceful finally. Like I said, our area has been through a lot, and I was just feeling really, really, really good. And then kind of in the back of my head, I was thinking, because all of the other times I've left Kais, the island has kind of given me a shell. It's been a flat. It's been like a really beautiful gaudy. And I'm literally thinking this. And then I look down and, oh, I guess it's going to be a horse conch today. So that's what Kais left me. My final shell was this really nice looking pony of a horse conch. And I just really enjoyed my time. Now you can do this too. The shells might not be quite as insanely awesome because I did go after a hurricane. Granted, it was on the East Coast and it just worked out that way. It was just the timing of it. And I figured, hey, I deserve a break too once in a while, right? So it really did work out. Look at this. This is not all of them, but this is a good chunk of the shells that I took. So of course we have the banded tulips and some of those lace murex. And I did get a couple of true tulips, which is always exciting. The Florida Fighting Conchs, I think I did a pretty good job. I only picked up a couple. And then the lightning whelk, some of those clams, the Sunray Venus clam, the calico clams, the pear whelk, which was really fun. I did find a false angel wing pear. Look at all of those spiny jewel box, the hinged spiny jewel box, so awesome. A giant Atlanta cockle, some of those paper figs, some jingles, the Florida prickly cockle, and the horse conchs. I got a couple of like nice size ones, so really happy with that. And back over, so we got some top snails. We did get a couple of scallops, a couple of real pretty olives, a couple augers, the apple murex, and then some moon snails. We have those colorful moon snails as well as the shark eyes. And then the center of awesomeness being all of those alphabet cones, the Florida cones, the limpet, the Sanibel torrid, the rose murex, and really my favorite of the day was that octopus and seeing the live Gaudinautica too. So it's really nice to bring things and memories off the beach. So it was really, really super fun. Patreons, thank you so, so very much for choosing to support me. Every week I say it, I really do appreciate each and every one of you. And thank you so, everybody else, thank you so much for watching, your comments, your love. I feel it. I do. I feel the love and I appreciate you. Don't know what's going to happen next week. I'm not really sure if I can share a video or if I'm not going to be able to, but I'll try, I'll try my best to get something to you. Just please be understanding. My circumstances have changed dramatically. You have a great week, and I'll see you as soon as I can.